Kings still continue to get some time in the offensive zone. Good sign.
Doughty gaining the zone. Oh, Kovalchuk! What a goal! Ilya Kovalchuk redirects it past Connor Hellebuck for his first goal as an LA King.
And that's exactly what we were talking about. That is transition speed, where you don't have it, you get it, and then you go right to the other team's zone and you get it there. Now, Kovalchuk has scored a lot of goals in the NHL, but watch this. He ends up with a backhand jab at the puck. There's really no release point on this, but look at this. Once behind, once up, and then far side, left side, keep going, keep going. That pass is in between for Kovalchuk. And he has a great time celebrating, but it's in between. It's not far enough back.
Anderson in the morning skate. Ready, Garrett Sparks. Kovalchuk scores! Ilya Kovalchuk on the second effort gets it through Garrett Sparks, and the Kings are on the board.
And the quick attack by the Kings. The counterattacks and the regroups have been pretty good here to start the second period by the Kings. So we talk about a fast Toronto team. The Kings right now at this point in the game are actually out skating. Look at that. Again, it's Iofalo with one touch on it. He gets to a loose puck right here and knows exactly what he wants to do with that puck before it gets on his stick. And what that does, it puts Kovalchuk in a much better position, because now Ilya, with the quickness on the release, you'll see the goaltender watch him move once sideways, but there's holes there.
Collected by Brown, cycles to Kopitar. Kopitar stops at the hashes. Centers for Doughty, moving in. Doughty up top, Kovalchuk scores! Oh. And this game is tied!
Can you say laser? Because that was, and there's a lot of movement that's impressive before the actual shot. The way the Kings changed the side of the ice. One side, all the way to the other. Penetration, then back. So you have east-west, north-south. With all that motion, someone's gonna be open. And we were just talking about establishing Kovalchuk as a shooter. Watch this. Man, that can't be anymore.
The Kings have struggled there, getting the defenseman involved in the attack.
Toffoli centers, shot juggled by Elliott, and it trickles in! Either Carter or Kovalchuk got it in the end. But the Kings have closed the gap, back to one.
Once again, the penetration, it's just happened here, so the Kings do get that important goal, the last 2 minutes of a period. But look at, again, look at the Kings are attacking right to the same spot Kopitar had. One chance, second chance, third chance is good. Kovalchuk will get it. One of the keys tonight, second and third chance opportunities. It's not necessarily clean right there, but it's clean right there. But with Carter going to the net, you see Martinez, he's involved too. Right off to the side, the guy closest, that's Alec Martinez. That's a defenseman. That's something the Kings have been able to do the last two shifts in a row.
How about that fourth line group as this stretch pass gets to Toffoli? On for Kovalchuk, scores! Jack Campbell may have an assist on this.
Oh, yes, he does. It won't be the primary assist, but it will be the most important assist. And all the way down the ice for Ilya Kovalchuk. Second period, bad change period, right? The Ducks get caught in a change because Jack Campbell spots it. And watch the Kings get on the horses. The Kings are in a change too. All the way. That pass was made all the way, and no stopping. No stopping the shot. One timer. Toffoli did a good job too, how he picked that up and kept his motion staying.
Kopitar once more, Muzzin, Kempe loads up, this time took something off it. Chance for Leipzig, but Jones was down. Muzzin, Kovalchuk scores! Ilya Kovalchuk in his return to the lineup, and the Kings take a 1-0 lead.
Kings Rangers have been talking about finding a spot for Kovalchuk right here. Power play situation. One thing that's hurt them all year, entries. This one was clean. It was crisp. It was diagrammed, and the X's and O's were executed perfectly. Then the Kings really got the puck to the middle a couple times. Fake shot, lift the leg, and watch where this one goes. You cannot pick the spot any better than that. So you have the one-time opportunity. You want the puck in the middle at the top of the umbrella. The Kings get that in Muzzin. The fake shot.
Back. Kane shot over the glove of Quick. Here's Kovalchuk. He's going to have a break. Ilya Kovalchuk to win the game. Scores! What a return for Ilya Kovalchuk. Two goals and the game winner here in overtime.
So the missed shot, 3-on-3, you miss it, you're gonna pay for it. And there was a split second there where you're uncertain whether the goaltender's gonna go get the puck or whether Kovalchuk's gonna get there first. He keeps it simple. Again, over the pad, under the glove. Second goal on the night, Kings get a chance to celebrate, take advantage of the missed shot, Kings win it, OT.
To feed the puck out. Dion Phaneuf enters the zone with Dustin Brown moving in. Brown shot, save, rebound, score! Kopitar in front of the goal as well as Kovalchuk. And the Kings, with their top line, have tied the game.
So the Kings get it back. And if there's been a trend for the Kings, it's been a defenseman involved in the play. Phaneuf picks it off in the neutral zone and he makes the play. Look at, he goes through here. He doesn't stop. He keeps going. And even though he's not the primary man on this putback, it ends up with a redirection. Kovalchuk in behind. And for one of the few times tonight, the Kings get bodies to the front. But that started in the neutral zone. Dion Phaneuf has a read to make. He has an option. Do you just dump it in, or do you...
Kopitar, bottom of the circle. One-timer, Kovalchuk scores! A sight for sore eyes, isn't it? Power play goal for the Kings. Ilya Kovalchuk's ninth of the year.
Yeah, we've talked about it this year. The most puzzling thing probably around the Kings this year has been Kovalchuk's usage early on. Of course, he had the ankle issue with a bursa sack and he needed surgery, but you just hope that the Kings are looking for this opportunity, which is one-timer for Kovalchuk. And you can see how he crept in there. He was at a high position. By the time he takes the shot, see how he's out near the blue line, makes another timing pass. By the time he takes a shot, he's at the top of the circle now. That's a whole different thing. A whole different thing. Dustin Brown is there too, so there's a little bit of traffic.
Cleared ahead by Brown. Kopitar gains the zone. Kopitar spins, stays with the puck. Brown arrives, shoots, scores! Dustin Brown with the shot, and it may have been deflected on the way through. Ilya Kovalchuk in front of the goal, setting the screen and maybe getting a piece. The Kings have taken a 2-1 lead.
Kopitar and his patience here. Brown will get, watch this pass all the way across. Now from this point on, Kopitar takes over, watch this. He's ahead of the play, slows it up, protects, turns, spins, stick handle, and then Brown gets activated once again. I believe it hits Kovalchuk on the way. You'll see the shot. The skate, yes, that's going to count. No distinct kicking motion whatsoever off the outside of the skate. Very interesting how Brown started the play. And there's the deflection. The Kings take a 2-1 lead under 7.
Dustin Brown said it almost exactly like that. He probably played good 55 minutes against the Islanders. Just need to play a full 60 when you're in a team in their position. There's Kovalchuk with the goal. Uh-oh. Notice, 5-1 Kings.
You notice how no one's around him when he's skating over to the bench here? None of the other Kings want to get near him.
That's hilarious.
Just in case. So it comes on a turnover. That's created by Anja Kopitar. I mean, Dustin Brown's involved too. Everyone off the boards, chase down the puck, keep it going. Reverse attempt. And there's Kopitar picking off the pass. And by the time that happens, it's on the stick of Kovalchuk.
34 seconds left for the Kings on their power play. Carter feeds it out wide once again. Doughty straight away. Fakes. Dowdy to Kopitar. Back through. Handcuffed to Foley. He'll get a shot. And he scores! Kovalchuk!
Just when it looked like Kovalchuk was going to back off, that's when he decided to have a few stick handles and then shoot. So the cross seam pass doesn't work initially. Look at it, he's going to back off, right? He's going to back off. Then he's going to say, no, I'm going to turn and just fire. It looks like Kevin Miller provides a little bit of a screen. If I'm not mistaken, it goes between the legs of 86. And just an example of never a bad idea. Jeff Carter's around, and you can see with Rask, he has a difficult time moving. Well, this guy doesn't have a difficult time. He picks the corner.
The stanchion behind the goal to Foley. Checks Carlson. Kings have the puck. A shot through traffic. Wouldn't go through. Kopitar to Kovalchuk. They score! There's one.
And there was shot mentality there. They had a couple blocked, but they kept cranking it up. Get it back, get it back. Ends up being right down the middle of the ice. There's one shot blocked. Kovalchuk does not stop it here. It's not a screen. As you can see, clearly, Dustin Brown was not in the way, but that one is tagged perfectly. We've had a couple of lasers in this game. And it gets through the first wave. And no question getting through the second wave.
I'm a little bit nervous because you guys, you know, I don't really know a lot about hockey. I know that I love it and it's very exciting and the men are virile. You guys, I keep telling you I'm good luck. Alex, take it.
I've got it.
You've got it.
We'll take it. You get three in the first period. And Kovalchuk just cranks it up. Backhand pass, yes. That saves time for Jeff Carter. He protected the puck. Really not a screen. It's all about quickness here. You know what also? It's a soft pass.
Clearing their zone. But this is knocked free by Kovalchuk. And he has a break. Kovalchuk moves in. He scores! Ilya Kovalchuk still got it. 1-0.
We've talked so much about young players trying to make an impression. It's been a puzzling season. The usage of Ilya Kovalchuk, and maybe this is just an exclamation point that he wants to just put there. Creates the turnover, but watch this. When he gets it, protect space. Ilya, because of his experience, has an uncanny understanding of how much room he has. And he just gets a nice. See that little fake right there? He faked the goaltender.
Minute remaining at Staples Center. Empty net for the Golden Knights. Here's Kovalchuk, and he seals it. Here is Kovalchuk. Ilya Kovalchuk scores.
Keep it simple, right? He takes the angle on the play, but when he gets to the point of attack, watch this. There is no deke, and he did. Corey Crawford was off his angle here. The goaltender's still moving backwards, which...
For your LA Kings, number 17, Ilya Kovalchuk.
Kovalchuk set to kick things off. Scores! That looks like somebody who's been there before.
Unbelievable. Bad ice. Ilya Kovalchuk, just control it. Control it, wait for the goalie to commit. Look at the angle he's got, and he throws it right underneath the bar.
Drew gets the goal. Kovalchuk for the Kings.
Ilya Kovalchuk slows up, shoots, and scores. And Kovalchuk. A little patience at the end. Yeah, almost stopped.
You can't come to a stop.
Exactly.
If you do, then the referee can blow it down. But
This is a modern-day shootout move. Slow, slow, and he was going forward.
That's a modern-day goal scorer's goal.
Well, Kovalchuk, what a matchup of great shooters here. Kovalchuk trying to match Stamkos in on Vasilevsky. Scores! And Kovalchuk has made it 1-1 here in the shootout.
And I don't think there's a lot of deception here either. Watch Kovalchuk come in. He keeps the puck moving, but watches quickly to the back end. That move was too quick for the goaltender to figure out. There was a shoulder fake there by Kovalchuk.